most people in the world are looking to make a life worth living and a time worth having. You see, life worth living is the job that we're doing. A life worth living is the free time we have with our family and our friends and our social networks that keep us thriving. You see, it's not always about you, meaning the individual who's involved. It's often about a higher purpose, a better image, a professional network that can help you in times when it's hard. When we are alone in life, people presume we're alone, but in truth, we're never alone. There is always a God Almighty that is available to us at any time. When the arcs of the angels crack like that, people need to really hear it. They need to understand that God, Lord Jesus Christ, is raging. Odin is waging war in the heavens, and people are dying of COVID. The foolishness of administrators of our communities and our country are that people do not acknowledge God anymore in any way, in any shape, in any kind, even praying before a meal, even me. I do struggle when I'm alone and outside living instead of when I'm at home in front of my altar praying, when I'm dining in my own home. But what we know about the elderly is that they struggle. And they struggle as their cellular health declines. Every human being ages. Every human being loses time. Every human being has a right to their own life. The thunderclaps are going to continue on this audio cast, and there's not a lot I can do. The truth is, when you live outside in the world, after cybercrime, identity theft, and fraud, you really end up facing it all. People don't often think about that when they see someone who is indigent seated on the street. They don't ever consider, where does that person eat? Where does that person sleep? Where does that person bathe? How do they take a toilet break? How do they do things without having things stolen from them every day? I had things in my breast pocket that literally have been missing for several days. I had a very important federally protected list in a bag inside my pocket. It's no longer there. I did not remove it from my pocket. I did not drop it out of my pocket. I know that someone pilfered it from my pocket, committing a federal offense, violating the law, thinking they had power over me after all. What I know about God is that He is angry. He is so angry at people, at Americans, at citizens of the world, that He is giving many people COVID. When you abuse the rights of someone else, when you abandon a life with your selfishness, when you choose your property, volumes of it, stockpiling, hoarding it over others, God is not pleased. What we can do today to prepare for the elderly years is to start downsizing our homes, really looking at what's the most important for us to keep and what trinkets, what old treasures, what other things can we start to sell in garage sales for cash on the dollar. Cash on the dollar can be carried away in a simple box. The whole box, $20. This whole box, $30. That comforter, $10. It doesn't matter. As long as it's in increments of 10, people will buy it again and again. Sure, you can have old toys for kids for 25 cents here and 30 cents there, but a lot of times they're worth a lot more. They also can be donated to a store when they're that inexpensive. But someone's personal property, someone's collection, someone's Star Wars cards, someone's Star Wars collection, someone's baseball hats, someone's photographs, someone's gifts from people across the land, overseas, from Japan, do not belong to total strangers. And when a person's Hagoita, scroll, and Kakijiku, and others go missing, we can blame the security places. We can blame the storage lockers. We can blame the liars who thought they'd steal bags from a man put in jail. But what we know is that the law enforcement networks don't get paid a lot. It's not true. Some of them make a very good living in smaller cities. They do. 35 grand a year, 65 grand a year for someone who's seasoned. Marvelous. But they still have a life. They still have a wife or a spouse. They have to tend. They still have to pay bills. They still have to pay taxes. They still have to cover the cost, preferably, of their own vehicle. Unless, of course, they get to write off their personal mileage in the company car, like many of them do. The truth in life is that we all must make a living. You almost have money in the bank for surviving. And when you're in your 50s and having to start over after the liars of a community, the liars of an original family, the liars of stranger networks abuse you and abandon you, what are you supposed to do? You're supposed to continue thriving. And the only way you do that is keeping your attitude in check with God. Because God provides. And it doesn't matter whether you're an apostolic Christian, whether you're a Methodist, whether you're a Lutheran, whether you're a Catholic, whether you're a Wiccan, God still survives. But God only survives in the heart of a loving person. And safety in America is not around for people who are elderly bound. We have to be careful of our elderly. We have to pay attention to the predators. We also have to be careful of the elderly game. There are some people that are so smart that they pretend to be worse off than they are. They do it a lot for the attention, they do it a lot to gain information, and they do it a lot to distract people so that they can have other things on the other person's back or in their bags stolen while they're acting as if they are about three. You never really can tell a person's adult ADLs. What I know in my late life is that sometimes I needed a pen and there's nothing I can do about that. I had a black boy wake me up in the middle of the morning and beat my head up, literally stomping on it with his feet. And did they ever take that boy off the street? Not within any period of time after he did that to me. You see, the liars in the force do not do their job. I told the female officer, who was pretty marvelous and pretty hot to me, but the black man behind her did nothing about it. And that's the problem. We are tolerant of abuse. We are tolerant of abandonment, and we are tolerant of college students like to playing a game like a noose. The liar will always walk up and give some money, and then they'll say, God bless you, and you just want to smack them, because that is not how we handle God's blessings. We pray for people. We invite them to pray for us so that we're not praying for them. We're inviting them to pray in front of us so that we can know what's important to them. And once we learn what's important to them, we have to be willing to help them or walk away. I have a marvelous girl named Raven, allegedly, which is a name stolen from a network of mine. But maybe her name is really Raven, from That's So Raven of a television show with Bill Cosby's line. But what I can tell you about the situation is that all I needed was one thing. Truthfully, one thing. There was a promise of that, but there was no delivery in that. She did bring me Calmine lotion, but it was completely out of date. So how am I supposed to utilize that if it's out of date? How am I supposed to trust her with that is untrue? But the reality is, as marvelous as it is to talk to her, she was trying to convince me to be a truck driver for you. I'm like, no, I'm not about to learn how to drive a semi. As much as it might be fun, as much as there might be a sleeping unit in the back of it so that you could sleep one or two in a row, maybe four. Some of them are pretty large. But the reality is, to go to trucking school, yes, they will pay you. Yes, they need them. And yes, it can be a great living if you enjoy trucking, if you enjoy traveling. And I do. But I'd be more likely to trust the one I love with that truck than me. Not because I'm not a good driver, it's just because of narcolepsy that is enhanced by the illness of the land, where people use technology, people use drug phrenology, and people use CBD oils to harm people's lives.